We want to bring in meteorologist Heather Waldman now. So Heather, we know this is a significant storm.
It is, and the focus of course is on the state of Florida, as it should be. That's where the worst of the storm is going to be as it moves inland. We're talking winds of 100 plus miles per hour close to the center of the storm. That's how it looks at this point. Storm surge along a pretty large area of the Florida coast, from, you heard, the Nature Coast up into the Big Bend area on the peninsula, over 12 feet, and rain in Florida upwards of 8 inches. But with this storm, it's going to hold together pretty well as it moves farther to the north. So we see a pretty high potential for inland flooding with up to 6 inches of rain into the southern Appalachians, an area that would be prone to flash flooding. So here's what the storm looks like now, a Category 1 hurricane, and you can see some of those outer rain bands already moving into Florida. Also, moisture developing now along the Appalachians into northern Georgia and into the Florida Panhandle. That's not with the storm itself. That's another system drawing moisture from the storm farther to the north. So look at Futurecast here. Just look at all the rain out ahead of it. This is before the storm even makes landfall. That'll be later tomorrow, likely mid-afternoon our time. Futurecast showing the storm making landfall at about 8 o'clock in the evening our time, quickly moving northward, but likely maintaining hurricane status even as it moves across Georgia. We're going to be talking about this for at least a few days. Back to you.
All right, Heather, thank you so much.